Good day and greetings from the Great White North. My name is Prickly Poo and welcome to day 187 of A Year of Change. Today, normally I do like a, well, this is sort of going to be the same thing. Normally on Thursdays we do like a study or a news article, something like that. And although this is sort of a news article, it's really more of a kind of thing. I love it when people just sort of are very straightforward and not necessarily blunt, but blunt is so much better because they don't sort of tiptoe around everything. There's so many times that you'll see someone discussing a topic, or it's like mainly like politician sort of things, where someone will ask a question and they skirt around the issue because they don't want anyone to feel bad. So they say, well, this is sort of where it, that, what am I trying to say? It's where it comes from, where it comes from. I haven't started this off very well at all. All right, let's start over. That sort of doublespeak that people have, that sort of fosters the idea that, oh, this isn't our fault the way that we are. Yes, we're going to sort of keep it pertaining to us being fat, where people will say, you know, what can I do to start losing weight? What can I do to get healthier and start exercising? What would be your tips? Back and forth. I don't know what I'm saying at all to start this out. Anyway, this will make sense once things get to where they need to be. Usually people will come back with something and say, well, you know, there are a number of different things that sort of go on that are contributing factors. It could be genetics, it could be this, it could be that, and it just really skirts around the issue. And in a roundabout way, they do still say, well, you really need to exercise more and eat healthier, and just things that we don't want to hear. We generally want to hear, we just know, here's what you need to do. Do this, take this pill, you'll be fine. It's not your fault. You're big boned. There's a classic one, which don't really think that we hear anymore. And it's very rare to have someone just say, no, you're eating too much. You know you're eating too much. You know what you need to do. You just need to do it. Which then you go into Shia LaBeouf territory, screaming, do it. But it's very rare to have that sort of blunt, yeah, this is what you need to do. And this is what today is sort of based on. There is a study that came out for the Heart and Stroke Foundation. And it actually goes from, I think, 1938 all the way up to 2011. So it's quite a long way, or quite a long time. I've buggered this whole thing up, haven't I? And it just shows how much more that we spend on processed food versus unprocessed food. And this was a study done by, can't remember his name, for the Heart and Stroke Foundation. And the spokeswoman for the Heart and Stroke Foundation basically said what it comes down to is we don't need to cut out the fat. We don't need to cut out, you know, specific nutrients back and forth. And she said just simply stop eating crap. Which is just a nice way of saying what we've been saying since day one. We just need to stop eating shit. It's common sense stuff. It's a lot of it is simply, okay, we need to stop eating so much junk food. We need to stop eating so many foods that are just high in sugar and fat and salt and everything that you know. Basically, when someone says, okay, is this bad for me? Yes, we know what that is bad for us. That's why it tastes so good. And, you know, all the healthy foods that sort of that we've been adding in, we've been doing it slowly because people are just generally averse to it because we aren't hardwired that way. We're hardwired to enjoy lots of sugar and lots of fat and lots of salt. And it's, I mean, that's the majority of junk food and processed food in general is designed to be just jam-packed full of that so that we get more of it because it's good. Not because, I mean, I don't really think, we've talked about this before, I don't think it's a matter of corporations saying, all right, well, we need to make people so that you'll get addicted to this so that they're going to eat 20 of them. Some of them might be, but in general, I think it's just a matter of, I think there's actually, I want to say it's the bliss ratio or something. I can't remember what it's called. But the word bliss is in there somewhere. And what it is, it's the measurement of sugar to fat to salt in a food that makes it absolutely perfect. Where, you know, it's not sweet enough, and then it's too sweet, so they need to find that one little spot, and then they add in the fat and the salt and everything else. And it is, you know, formulaic, and almost every food company does it to find that that certain point where everything comes together and it tastes really, really good. And that's what they do. That's, I mean, part of it is so that people will buy their product over someone else's, but I don't think there's really a matter of them saying, oh, we're going to do this so that we can make people fat and have them keep coming back. I'm sure it is a matter of we're going to do this so that people will come back and keep eating our stuff more than anyone else's, which is fine. It's a business. That's what you're expected to do. But, lost my train of thought there. What are they talking about? Yes. Anyway, Heart and Stroke Foundation. that all these processed foods coming together, we know which ones are good, which ones are bad. We know when we go into a store that if we're buying something, like a bag of chips, doesn't matter what brand, what kind, we know that they're bad for us. No one ever has bought a bag of chips and went, oh, these are healthy. These are really good for me. These are going to be exactly the same as buying an apple. Some people, well, you know what? Some people have. Some people do that. They are really, really, really good at lying to themselves. Some of us have probably done that when we go, oh, well, they're low-fat chips. They must be good for you. But in general, just regular, just going in and buying a regular bag of potato chips, we know that it's bad for us. We know it's junk food. And that's essentially what the spokeswoman said from the Heart and Stroke Foundation. She just went, just stop eating the crap. I mean, it's good that we're looking at salt and fat and everything else, and that's really what they focused on was saturated fat. And they said, you know, it's not, like, just cutting out fat isn't going to be one of those things that's going to help you lose weight. Because just by cutting that out, and we keep sort of doing a, I'm picturing cutting fat off a pork chop or something. By cutting out fat, that's not going to help us lose weight. It's not going to help you get healthier. It is better, but there's not one thing that's going to actually do it. Paying attention and saying, well, I need to cut out fat, and then I'm going to cut out refined sugar. Things like that. I mean, she's basically saying it's an overall diet plan that we need to look at, that we need to eat more fruits and vegetables and stop eating so much processed stuff. Eat more stuff that you prepare yourself from home. You know, and there she sort of goes through and flat out says, everyone knows this. It's just a matter of, you know what? We just need to eat better. So that's pretty much what this is. I mean, I'm going to put a description and link below just to cite the actual study, but it was this very blunt, stop eating crap sort of thing that really stood out that I'm really hoping would be the very first of a trend of physicians and dietitians and health experts that are just saying, people, you know what you need to do. This isn't a matter of saying, well, this is the new science that's saying that we need to do this and this and this. There, I mean, there's always new information coming in. There's always, you know, changes in old facts that are now no longer valid. But in general, we know what we need to do. We've known what we've needed to do since day one, since we very first started in on this 6 months ago. It's just we need to stop eating so much shit, and we need to start exercising. We need to start living better. And part of that is eating more fruits and vegetables and getting away from the junk food and the fatty foods and not eating buckets of cheese and, you know, an entire package of bacon. I've done both. Not an actual bucket of cheese, but, you know, the great big blocks. I know, I can't think of an exact time, but I know the big blocks of cheese, which are about 500 grams. So almost a full pound. Well, actually, no, I think that actually is like 1.1 pounds. So over a pound of cheese. I know that I have in the past when I've made nachos or something like that, because of how much cheese I put on nachos and I've had two or three plates in one sitting, I have had an entire block in one sitting. At some point, I know I have. Same thing with bacon. I know that at some point in the past, I can't really think of when, but I know that there's no way around it. The way that I was eating, that I've eaten an entire package of bacon in one sitting. I know that I have. Or at the very least, within a day, which is an insane amount of bacon. But it's stuff like that that we know we shouldn't be doing. It's just trying to get ourselves to that point where, you know, we aren't doing that anymore. And it's been tough. It hasn't been a matter of us just saying, all right, well, you know what? Tomorrow I'm going to hit the gym. I'm going to stop eating all this junk food. And I'm going to start eating fruits and vegetables. I'm going to go vegan and gluten-free and all the other organic shit that you don't really need. It's been a very, very slow process, and I think that's why we've stuck with it. For me, anyway, this is why it's been working, because each week when we did our changes, you know, it's been little tiny incremental ones, And it's been a little easier to manage because we haven't cut anything out. We haven't, you know, drastically changed our diet. We've gradually added more fruits and vegetables, which has sort of replaced the bad food. And we're still having those bad foods every once in a while. I had hot dogs for the first time in about... I don't know if I've had hot dogs since we started this. And normally I would have probably... Well, normally I would have three in a single sitting. And if I was hungry, I'd have four. And then probably make more. And I was starving. I hadn't had anything all day. I was very, very hungry because I hadn't eaten properly. Sorry. And I thought, I'm really craving hot dogs. And I thought, no, I'm going to start with two. And then I'll wait. Two filled me to capacity. So, which I'm very happy about. Anyway, it's off topic. Basically, what this is, this study, I'm going to put this in the link in the description below as well so that you can go up and take a look at it. It was just one of those things. It's not really any new information. It's not the same, aside from the study itself, it's a 70-year study. But aside from the person just saying, stop eating crap, we know what we need to do. They show a little bit the amount of money that we've spent on fresh fruit and vegetables and stuff like that has dropped over time. The amount that we're paying for processed food has doubled. It's gone up to 60 or 70% or something like that over the 70-year period. And a lot of that, is going to be because there's a lot more available processed food out there. It's a lot cheaper for people to buy. But again, we know that it's bad for us. We know that it's stuff that we shouldn't be eating. It's not really new information. It's just refreshing to see someone just flat out say, no, you know what you need to do. Smarten up. Because really, part of what we've been doing has been just accepting responsibility for it and not blaming genetics or big bones or any of the other stuff. We can acknowledge that there are contributing factors to us being fat. But the vast majority of it, probably 90% of it, is our behavior. We are the ones that have to go out. We have to go buy the food. We have to bring it home. We have to cook it or microwave it or whatever, or open the bag. We have to eat the entire bag in one sitting. It's our behavior that has really led to us being the way that we are. Whether there are contributing factors to it, whether it's emotional or psychological or physical or anything like that, our behavior does dictate how much that we're eating. And we've really accepted responsibility for that. And I think that's probably part of the reason why we've been successful in doing what we're doing. Because we aren't saying, well, there's no out for us. There's no way for us to say, well, you know, it didn't work because it's not my fault. And here's why, because of this and this and this and this. We've really just sort of said, no, I have to change because if I don't, I'm just going to go back to eating the way that I was. That's right. I'm trying to think of eating the way that I did. There we go. That's probably better. Eating the way that I was. That didn't make sense. It didn't sound right. And I knew when it came out, it didn't sound right. So yes, if I don't curb this behavior, I'm going to go back to eating the way that I did before I started. And I'm just going to balloon up and then I shall become the weight that I was. That still doesn't sound right, but I think it's grammatically correct. Anyway, this has sort of been all over the place, and I am sorry because normally this is something where I say, well, there's the study and here's the new information, and now you can take this and you can utilize it. There really isn't. Aside from showing over a 70-year period how much more we spend on processed food, it's just that it fit in with what we've been doing over the past couple of weeks, looking at sodium and looking at fat, and starting next week when we start looking at sugar, that, you know, trying to cut back on processed foods, not because of evil corporations or anything, just because we know that it's not as healthy for us as cooking something fresh from home. Obviously there are time constraints and real life is going to interfere, and you're going to just have those days where you think, I'm too tired. I just want to throw a pizza in. You know, we'll be fine that way. It's not going to kill us. But the fact that we're eating, you know, three meals a day out of a box is not healthy. And this just sort of flat out said, yeah, everyone knows this. So smarten the fuck up. So it was really refreshing to sort of see that in there. And I know it's only a snippet of, what they said, but it does sort of go on to explain, exactly why. And you can go up and actually take a look at the study as well. There's a quick summary. I'll put a link in there below. And if you want a little bit more information that way. But in general, it was nice to be able to see someone say, people, you know what you need to do. Eat more fruits and vegetables. Cut out the junk food. Stop buying processed stuff and eat stuff at home. Prepare it yourself. It's going to be better for you. There's less salt, there's less sugar, there's less fat, and you have a much greater control over what you're putting into your body that way. it doesn't really go into all the, you know, organic or gluten-free or any of the other little trendy things. It's really trying to be kind. Trendy things that people say to say, oh, well, I need to be healthy, so I have to have this and this and this and this and this and this. You don't. Just, you know, use common sense. And part of that is not eating everything that comes out of a box. You're going to be able to prepare your own stuff. Even if you're still buying, say, you know, those little ready meals of pasta with sauce and everything else. Even if you're buying a better sauce and regular pasta, it's still better than just getting it out of a box and microwaving it, because it has so much stuff packed into it. And they, part of it is that they need to do that because they need to preserve it. It needs to last on the shelves for a year or in the freezer or whatever. But part of it is as well that, you know, they're adjusting everything so that it tastes so much better. Which again is one of those sort of contributing factors to it, that yes, it tastes much, much better than having just homemade mushroom soup. But those are the sort of things that we've been working on. I was going to say that we need to work on, but we've been working on it for 6 months and it's been doing well. Anyway, I've been all over the place with this one, so go and take a look at it. I'll put the quick story down below as well. It's mainly from the Heart and Stroke Foundation. And although they're a charitable organization, they do have real scientists working for them. So, and healthcare professionals. So this isn't just a matter of them saying, oh, well, you need to do this, and we have no scientific evidence to back it up. I'll put the scientific evidence in there as well, where you can go in and take a look at the study showing how much more processed food that we're eating. And we've already gone through, you know, the amount of salt and fat and sugar and everything else that gets packed into them, especially the low-fat stuff, oddly enough. And, you know, a lot of it, again, you're going to sort of read through it and just go, yeah, this is common sense. It's stuff that we know. It's nice to have someone bluntly say it instead of sort of tiptoeing around the issue to prevent us from feeling bad, which is what I originally started talking about at the beginning of this video. When people sort of skirt around the issue and say, well, we need to do this. I'm trying to think of a good example. Someone trying to avoid saying that you're fat. Saying, well, you're not going to be able to fit into a chair that we have because our accommodations aren't designed for this specific situation. Just say, I'm too fat. Say, you can't fit in their chair, you're too fat. I'd much rather hear that, because then I can go, okay, now I know how to deal with it. Skirt around the issue, not going to know what they're going to do. Anyway, I didn't really clarify that very well. But I'm going to leave this video here, so you can go up and take a look at the information. So thank you very much for watching. If you liked it, please poke the like button for me. In the meantime, keep yourself warm and fuzzy, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.